In this class, I am going to derive numerical problems on economic aspects of power generation. Up now, we have discussed about load curve, load duration curve, demand factor, diversity factor, and so on, etc. From this, we are going to solve the problems. Let us go through the problem. A power station has a maximum demand of 1500 kilowatt, that is 15,000 kilowatt. The annual load factor is 50%, and plant capacity factor is 40%. Determine reserve capacity of the plant. In this problem, a power station, that is the power plant, they are not mentioned. That is thermal power plant, hydro power plant, nuclear, gas or diesel power plant, or else the renewable energy sources, solar and wind. Simply, they are represented a power station as a maximum demand of 15,000 kilowatt. In the particular power plant, the maximum demand is 15,000 kilowatt. The maximum demand means they are taken for the peak load. Here, the plant capacity is different. But in the particular power plant, they are represented for the maximum demand, that is 15,000 kilowatt. Again, the load are classified for two types. One is for the base load, another one is for the peak load. For example, we can take, this is a diesel power plant. The plant capacity is 16,500 kilowatts. This is nothing but the plant capacity. That is, in that, the generation capacity is 16,200 kilowatt. But on the particular day, how much demand in the particular power plant? 15,000 kilowatt. This 15,000 kilowatt is peak load. Again, the load are classified for two types. One is for the base load, another one is for the peak load. Base load means throughout the period, the load is maintained for constant. That is from starting point to up to the ending point on a particular day or particular week or month or throughout the period. That is throughout the year, 365 days, the load is maintained for constant. For example, you can take in the particular power plant, the base load is suppose 9,200 megawatt or 10,000 kilowatt or 9,500 kilowatt, so on, etc. This is considered for the base load. It is not depending for the season. It is not depending for the climate condition. Throughout the period, the load is maintained for constant, that is represent for base load. Peak load means within short interval of time, the load is raising. After that, it is coming from the actual position. Within short interval of time is, that is either half an hour or 1 hour or 40 minutes, maximum two hours. And on average, in a day, the peak load is concentrated for 4 to 6 hours. And one more thing, this peak load, it should be varying based upon the season, based on the climate condition. Throughout the day, suppose today the peak load is 1,500 megawatt. Suppose tomorrow the peak load is not same. Either it should be 1,500 or 1,550 or 560 or 1,330, 320, so on, etc. But the base load is constant. It is not depending for the climate condition. It is not depending for the season. Throughout the period, throughout the year, the load is maintained for constant. That is represented for base load. And peak load means within short interval of time, the load is increasing or decreasing. And one more thing, throughout the period, it is not made constant. That is today, the peak load is different. Tomorrow, the peak load is, it should be varying and day after tomorrow. But the peak load, it should be depending based upon the season, And season condition, some amount of the variation is available. For example, you can take, this is the time we are taken in the x-axis, the time we are represented in terms of hours, the time we are taken in the x-axis, and y-axis we are taken in the load. The load we are taken in terms of kilowatt or megawatt. In the power station, we are sending the power in terms of megawatt. But in the distribution side, we are represented in terms of kilowatt. The load we are taken in terms of kilowatt or megawatt. Now, the time we are taken, the each duration I am considered for the 4 hours. That is 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. or else you can take 2 hours also. That is 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 124. Up to now, this is considered for the forenoon. Remaining, it is considered for the afternoon. Here, for example, we can take the load we are taken for either 200 kilowatt, 400, 600, so on, up to 2000 kilowatt. Now here, 1200 kilowatt is considered for the base load. That is, throughout the period, the load is maintained for constant. This is represented for the base load. Peak load means within short interval, or for example, you can take the early morning. So the load is coming from the peak load. Again, it is coming from the actual position. And afternoon, it will be goes. Evening, this is considered for the peak load. Now you can observe here, in this short interval of time, the load is increasing suddenly. After that, coming from the actual position. Here, this is not maintained for the constant. Again, increasing, decreasing. Again, the slightly it is increased. It is not depending for the season. It is not depending for the climate condition. And one more thing, the peak load, it should be varying differently. It is not maintained for the constant. Here in this, the particular power station, they are not mentioned. That is either thermal power plant, hydro power plant, nuclear, gas or diesel power plant. The particular power plant, the maximum demand is 15,000 kilowatts. And the annual load factor is 50%. That is the annual load factor they are given per annum, per year. How much? 50%. That is 50 by 100, we are getting 0.5. And the plant capacity factor, that is the plant capacity factor is 40%. That is 40 by 100, 0.4. And we want to determine reserve capacity factor. How much we can store the power excess of the demand. For example, you can take here in this the plant, the capacity is 16,500 kilowatt. The plant capacity is 16,500 kilowatt, but the generation capacity is 16,200 kilowatt. How much is the maximum demand? 15,000. What about the remaining reserve capacity? That is 1200 kilowatt is reserve capacity. 1200 kilowatt is reserve capacity. How we are representing is already we know the plant capacity is 16,500 and the generating capacity is 16,200. Here the maximum demand in the particular power plant is 15,000 kilowatt. How much the reserve capacity? Total generation capacity minus maximum demand, that is 1200 kilowatt is reserve capacity. But in the particular problem, they are given only the maximum demand. We don't know the generation capacity. For that, we can calculate that one. At that time, we can find out for the reserve capacity. Now, note down the what are the data they are given. Go through that problem. A power station, that is, they are not mentioned any power plant. Simply, they are given for the power station. That is, we can assume that is either thermal power plant or hydro power plant, nuclear, gas, and then diesel power plant. Here, they are given for the maximum demand is 15,000 kilowatt. The maximum demand is 15,000. Kilowatt. Next, they are given annual load factor. That is the load factor per annum. 1 year they are given load factor. That is they are represented for the 50%. 50%. That is 50 by 100, 0.5. And next, they are given for the plant capacity factor. That is the plant capacity factor. Here they are given 40%. That is 40 by 100, 0.4. 40 by 100, 0.4. Here we want to find out, that is determine reserve capacity of the plant. We want to find out how much the reserve, that is excess amount power generation is available. This the total generation capacity minus demand. We are getting the reserve capacity. That is reserve capacity already we know that it is the difference between plant capacity minus maximum demand. Here, the plant capacity is how much means the remaining is considered for the reserve capacity. The previous already we have taken one example. That is the plant capacity is 16,500 kilowatt. Here the maximum demand is 15,000 kilowatt. That is total this one you can getting for the reserve capacity, that is the plant capacity minus maximum demand. Here we want to find out the plant capacity. What is the plant capacity? Energy generated per annum divided by product of plant capacity into hours of year. That is, plant capacity is defined as the ratio of energy generated per annum to the product of plant capacity and then hours in a year. By year we have taken hours in a year. That is energy generated. That is units generated we have taken per annum. Per annum. Suppose here we have taken units generated per day means number of hours in a day. Here we have taken month means number of hours in a month. Here hours in a year means in a year 365 days. In a year 365 days per day how many hours? 24 hours. Per day 24 hours. And here we want to again the plant capacity data is there, that is plant capacity data, and hours in a year we know, but units generated per annum, that is energy generated per annum, we don't know. We need to calculate based upon the available data. That is energy generated per annum, it is product of maximum demand, load factor and hours in a year. Maximum demand, load factor and hours in a year. Hours in a year means that is per day 24 hours, per year 365 days. Now data is available, substitute. Maximum demand is how much? 15,000. The load factor is 50%, 0.5. The load factor is 0.5. Hours in a year, that is per day 24 hours, per year 365 days. That is 365 into 24, we are getting the value is 8,760. We are getting the value is 8,760. Now you can multiply this one. We are getting the answer is 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6 kilowatt hour. 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6 kWh. That is already we are getting the unit is kilowatt. Here we are taken in terms of hours. That is 15,000 kilowatt. Here we are representing in terms of hour. That is we are getting the unit is kWh. Now we know the value of energy generated per annum. We can calculate the plant capacity. That is units generated per annum. Energy generated per annum is how much? 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6 by the plant capacity is how much? 40%. That is 0.4 into hours in a year, 8,760. That is units generated per annum. That is energy generated per annum is 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6 by the load factor is 0.4 and number of hours in a year, that is 8,760. 24 into 365 days. Now finally we are getting 18,750 kilowatt. Here the numerator hours and denominator hour gets cancelled. That is you are getting 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6 kWh by here 8,760. That is in terms of hour. That is numerator and denominator hour gets cancelled. So finally we are getting the unit is kW. That is 18,750 kilowatt. Now we know the value of plant capacity and the maximum demand. We can find out for the reserve capacity. That is the reserve capacity means that is plant capacity minus maximum demand. What is the plant capacity value? 18,750. What is the maximum demand in the particular plant? 15,000. Total, that is 3,750 is concerned for the reserve capacity. 3,750 is concerned for the reserve capacity. In this the problem, they are given the data, a power station has a maximum demand of 15,000 kilowatt. In the particular power plant, the demand is 15,000 kilowatt. That is, they are considered for the peak load. Always we are taken for the demand is peak load demand. Here, the demand is 15,000 kilowatt and they are given the data, annual load factor 50% and the plant capacity factor 40%. Here we want to find out the reserve capacity of the plant. The reserve capacity of the plant. But we don't know the value of the plant capacity. Once if you find out the plant capacity, the reserve capacity means what is the plant capacity minus maximum demand? We are getting the reserve capacity. That much of power we can generate it. Now here we are note down the data. That is the demand factor is 15,000 kilowatt and the load factor is 50%. That is 0.5, 50/100. And the plant capacity factor is 40%, that is 0.4. And we want to find out the reserve capacity. Already we know that it is defined as the difference of plant capacity to the maximum demand. Here the maximum demand is 15,000 kilowatt. We want to find out plant capacity. What is the plant capacity? It is defined as the ratio of energy generated. Here we are considered per annum. That is the plant capacity we are considered per annum. That is units generated per annum or energy generated per annum to the product of plant capacity into hours of here. Hours of here. Now here, energy generated per annum we want to find it. Energy generated per annum we want to find it. That is the maximum demand into load factor into hours in a year. What is the maximum demand? 15,000. Load factor is 50% and years of here 8,760. Now we can substitute this parameter in the plant capacity. Units generated per annum, that is energy generated per annum, is 65.7 into 10 to the power of 6. And plant capacity factor, is 0.4 and hours in a year, per day 24 hours and year 365 days. That is 365 into 24, we are getting 8,760. That is finally we are getting the plant capacity 18,750. Now we can find out the reserve capacity. That is plant capacity minus the next, we will move for the next problem. Go through the problem. A generating station has the following daily load cycle. They are represented time 0 to 6 hours and 6 to 10. The load is 0 to 6, 40 megawatt and 6 a.m. to 10 a.m., 50 megawatt and 10 to 12 p.m., 60 megawatt and 12 p.m. to 16, that is 4 p.m., 50 megawatt and 16 to 20, that is 4 to 8, 70 and 20 to 24, that is 4 to 10 p.m. and 10 to again 12 a.m. 40 megawatt. Here they are given for the different hours, different load. Different hours, different load. And what about the load? The load they are given in terms of megawatt. Here we want to draw the load curve and find, we want to determine maximum demand, units generated per day, average load, and then load factor. Average load and then load factor. Now just you can note down the what are the data they are given. Time 0 to 6, that is the first 6 hours. How much the load? 40 megawatt. 0 to 6 in the sense 12 a.m. early morning 12 a.m. to up to the 6 a.m. the demand is 40 megawatt. And 6 to 10, that is 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. How many hours? 4 hours. That is the 4 hours, 50 megawatt. 50 megawatt. And again 10 to 12, that is 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. again 2 hours, the load is 60 megawatt. The load is 60 megawatt. And 12 to 6, that is 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. how many hours? 4 hours. Again the load is how much? 50 megawatt. 50 megawatt. And 6 to 20, again 4 hours, that is 4 to 8, 4 to 8 a.m. again the load is 70 megawatts. Again 20 to 24. Again remaining 4 hours, the load is 40 megawatts. There is total in a day 24 hours. This load is there. You can observe 40 megawatt, 50 megawatt, 60. Again 50, 70, 40 megawatt. You can observe here in this the tabulation, 40 megawatt is the base load. That is, the lowest load is considered for the 40 megawatt. This is comes for the base load. What about the peak load? The peak load is 70 megawatts. The different. That is, here the peak load is 50. Again, it should be varying 10 megawatt. Again, it is reduced. Again, increasing. Again, it is increasing. In the particular plant, they are not represented either thermal power plant or nuclear power plant. In the particular power plant, the base load is 40 megawatt and the peak load is 70 megawatt. This is nothing but the maximum demand. Here we want to draw the load curve. That is, we can take plot the load curve. X-axis we are taken time in terms of hours, and y-axis we are taken load in terms of kilowatt or megawatt. Kilowatt or megawatt. Now, that is, you can take that is 4, 6, 8, so on, etc. First, the 6 hours, the load is 40 megawatt. That is 40 megawatt. Again, the load is increased to 60 megawatt. Again, 4 hours. Again, 4 hours. Again, the load is 2 hours increased to 60 megawatt. Again, 4 hours, the load is decreased to 50 megawatt. Again, 4 hours, the load is increased to 70 megawatt. And again, it is comes from the actual position. Like that, we need to draw for the load curve. Now, just to go through this problem, a generating station, they're not mentioned, the which generating station has the following daily load curve. Here, they are given for the daily load curve. Time represented in terms of hour, load in the data they are given in terms of megawatt. That is, note down the data. First 6 hours, that is 12 a.m. to 6 a.m. First 6 hours, how much the load? 40 megawatt. First 6 hours, the load is 40 megawatt. And next 6 to 10, next 4 hours, 6 to 10 is how much? 50 megawatt. Next 2 hours, that is 10 to 12, 60 megawatt. Next 12 to 6, next 4 hour, how much? 50 megawatt. 50 megawatt. Next 16 to 20. Next 4 hours, how much? 70 megawatt. And 20 to 24. Next 4 hours, how much? 80 megawatt. 80 megawatt. First, we have note down the different time period, the different load is, that is the base load and then peak load. We are note down the different value. That is, first 6 hour, 40 megawatt. Next 4 hour, 50 megawatt. Next 2 hour, 60 megawatt. Next 4 hour, 50 megawatt. Next 4 hour, 70 megawatt. And last 4 hour, 40 megawatt. 40 megawatt. Now, first we want to draw the load duration curve. And in that we want to find out maximum demand, units generated per day. That is nothing but energy generated per day. Clearly they are mentioned. Here we want to find out per day. And average load factor. Again, the average load factor and then average load and then load factor. These parameters we need to find out in this the problem. So first we want to draw the load curve. In this problem, clearly they are mentioned. We want to draw for the load curve. That is, the load curve can be plotted in between time as well as for the load. The time we are taken in the x-axis and the load we are taken in the y-axis. The load we are taken in the y-axis. That is, x-axis the time we are represented in terms of hour, and the load we are represented in terms of kilowatt or megawatt. The load we are represented in terms of kilowatt or megawatt. But in the problem, clearly they are represented in terms of megawatt. That is, the time period we are taken, each duration is 2 hours, 2, 4, 6, 8, so on up to the 24. That is, up to now it is represented for the AM, remaining it is represented for the PM. And y-axis we are taken load in terms of megawatt. The each duration we are taken for 10 megawatt, 10 megawatt. Now, the first 6 hours is how much? 40 megawatt. That is, the first 6 hours drawn for the 40 megawatt. And next 4 hours, it is 50 megawatt. That is, 10 megawatt is increased. That is, next 4 hours up to 10 a.m. And next 2 hours, the load is increased to 60 megawatt. That is, next 10 to 12, that is, the demand is 60 megawatt. And 4 hours, next 4 hours, the load is reduced to 50 megawatt. That is, again, these the 4 hour, the load is reduced to 10 megawatt, that is 50 megawatt. Next 4 hours, the load is increased to 70 megawatt. That is, again, it is goes to the next 4 hour, 70 megawatt. And again, it is fallen slightly. Next 4 hour, that is 40 megawatt. That is the next 40 megawatt. From this, the available given data, we are drawn for the load curve. From this load curve, we want to determine maximum demand, units generated per annum, average load, and then load factor. Clearly indicated in this the diagram, we want to derive the first parameter, that is the maximum demand. Clearly shows in the load curve, what is the maximum demand? you can observe the maximum demand here is 70 megawatts. 70 megawatts. And note down this value. That is, the maximum demand is 70 megawatt. The next, second one we want to find out. Units generated per annum. That is, energy generated per annum. Here, in this, the load curve, we can determine energy generated. That is, area it's covered in terms of kWh under the load curve. But here, already the available data is megawatt. Available data is megawatt. This we can convert it into kilowatt. That is 10 to the power of 3 into kilowatt. That is, the 1 mega means 10 to the power of 6. This we can split into 10 to the power of 3 into 10 to the power of 3. That is, a to the power of m into a to the power of n, a to the power of m plus n. That is, 10 to the power of 3 plus 3. We are getting 10 to the power of 6. 10 to the power of 6. This we can, megawatt we can convert it in terms of kilowatt. That is, 10 to the power of 3. Now, area in area under the load curve, that is the first six hours, 40 megawatt, and the next 4 hours, 50 megawatt, next 2 hours, 60 megawatt, next 4 hours, 50 megawatt, next 4 hours, 70 megawatt, next 4 hours, 40 megawatt. 40 megawatt is nothing but the base load, and peak load is 70 megawatt. Here, we are represented in terms of kWh, that is 10 to the power of 3 into, that is the first 6 hour into, load is how much? 40 kW. Here we have taken kW into hour, that is kWh, similarly, plus. And next how many hour? Next 4 hour into the load is 50 kilowatt. Plus, because already we have removed the 1K, 10 to the power of 3, that is in terms of mega we can replace for the kilo. Next, plus 2 into 60, plus 8, 4 into 50, plus 4 into 70, plus 4 into 40 megawatts. 40 megawatt. Now, let's simplify this one. That is 10 to the power of 3 into 40 kilowatt, 6 hours, plus 50 kilowatt into next 4 hours, plus 60 into 2 hours, next 50 kilowatt into next 4 hours. Plus 70 kilowatt into 4 hours. Next 40 kilowatt into next remaining 4 hours. Now we are simplifying. We are getting 12 into 10 to the power of 5 kWh. 12 into 10 to the power of 5 kWh. Now we have find out for the second parameter. Next, third one, we want to determine average load. What is the formula for average load? Here clearly mentioned units generated per day. In the problem, they are asking units generated per day. Here also, we want to find out average per day, how much load, that is units generated per day by 24 hours. How much units generated per day? That is 12 into 10 to the power of 5 by 24. Per day number of hours is 24. Simplifying, we are getting 50,000 kilowatt. 50,000 kilowatt. Next, last one, we want to find out the load factor. That is average load by maximum demand. What is the average load? 50,000. What is the maximum demand? 70 megawatt. That is 50,000 by, already that this is available in terms of kilowatts. Available in terms of kilowatt. But here it is available in terms of megawatt. That is 70 into 10 to the power of 3 kW. Now, we are simplifying. We are finally, we are getting the answer is 0.714. The load factor always represented in terms of percentage. That is 71.4. In the problem, they are given the data at different time interval. They are mentioned for the different load. From this data, we have drawn for the load curve. From this load curve, we can find out maximum demand, units generated per annum, average load, and then load factor. In this graph clearly shows that is the maximum demand is 70 megawatt and units generated per day, that is area covered in the kWh under the load curve. We can taken here megawatt they are given, that is 10 to the power of 3 in terms of kilo. Finally, we are getting 12 into 10 to the power of 5. And average load, that is unit.